Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. And I know whenever the subject of electricity comes up, everybody gets really nervous. Well, it shouldn't be that scary of a topic to cover, but one of the most asked questions is, well, what do I really need to dig into the system? Something as simple as just a test light, or do you need to step up and get what they call a multimeter? Well, that's what we're going to talk about right now. A test light is a very useful device, inexpensive, it's really easy to use, but basically all it's telling you is if there's electricity present there. And that may be all that you're looking for, but in most cases you need to know how much, you need to know the measurement of the voltage or amperage or resistance, and that's something that it simply can't do. And what the test light is very proficient at is giving you a quick look inside to see if you've got voltages and or if something is ground out, depending on how you connect it. You know, a simple voltage test to see if there's any electricity present, put that on the negative side, go to your positive, lights up. But it doesn't tell you how much voltage is actually present. That's where the digital voltmeter comes in. Now there's another neat way you can use a test light if you're trying to trace down a ground somewhere on your system. Simply move the clamp over to the positive side of the battery because it doesn't care about polarity. Now you can start picking apart that wire and find your ground. Now one thing I want to caution you about, if you're trying to trace out a bad wire or a grounded out wire on your fuel injection system, you have to be very careful when you're using a test light because most every single fuel injection system I know of out there is controlled by your ECU. And what you basically have here is a pathway to ground. And the grounds don't play very well when you're talking about an ECU. You can fry one in a hurry. Not that I've ever done it, but I've heard that it happens. So you've made the decision, all right, I need a DMM or a digital multimeter. Which one do I need to go with? Well, if you watched any of my electrical diagnostic videos, I always like using the Fluke unit. Really high quality and very accurate. But that doesn't mean you have to spend the money to get something this nice. For as little as $30, you can go with this little Lange unit that'll do all the basic requirements that the Fluke will do. It'll do resistance, voltage, AC and DC. It'll do a diode test. It will also do an amperage test, providing, of course, that you don't exceed its internal fuse, which I believe is 10 amps. One of the biggest difference in between these two units is the Fluke is actually automatic. When you switch it over to voltage, AC or DC, it automatically scales it to whatever the input happens to be. That's one of the disadvantages with the cheaper unit. It actually requires you to pick the range. So, just as an example, if you were going to do a battery voltage measurement on it, you'd want to put it in the 20 volts DC range. That gives it a range from zero all the way up to plus 20 volts. Let's see how much voltage this battery does have, just for fun. 12.40. Just for kicks, let's turn on our Fluke DC. Which one do you believe? I'd probably edge more toward the Fluke. But once again, 0.3 of a volt difference, actually 0.03. So that much of a difference, that small of a difference, you're safe to go with the Lange instead of the Fluke. Let's do a quick test of the diodes and compare the two meters. So we've got her in diode mode. Let's see what all kind of readings we get. Should be around 0.5. Yep. 5.51. And flip on our Fluke. Take it over to diode.
Four nine nine.
Is it a little off compared to the Fluke? Well, maybe just a tick, but that'll still tell you that the diodes are working in this particular unit. Now, if you do need help really diagnosing and looking into the inner workings of a regulator rectifier, we have a video for that you may want to go check out, where I take a relatively deep dive into what you can and can't see inside of one of these devices. So you've made the commitment to go ahead and diagnose whatever electrical problem you may be having. So which one do you need? Well, in my opinion, go ahead and get both. The test light is for quick and dirty when you're trying to see if there's voltage there or not, but being very mindful which circuit you're messing with, because we don't want to damage the ECU. I want to stress that. The multimeter is as its name implies. It has a multitude of uses, and they are actually so inexpensive right now, why would you not want that type of capability? So go ahead and put both of them in your toolbox. For a very small investment, you open up a large window when it comes to being able to look inside and diagnose your own machine. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And if you need a little help diagnosing your machine, check out our playlist. In every unit, we at least do one or two videos that deal with diagnosing electrical problems. If you have a specific question about a part or a tool, give us a call or send us a message and we can get that answer for you. Listen, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. So have a great day.